Today's SportSweaker tutorial is entitled JSON Web Token Authentication Bypass via Unverified Signature. To solve the lab, we must access the admin panel and delete the user Carlos. First off, let's open Burp Suite and install a useful extension for viewing and modifying JSON Web Tokens. Go to Extensions, B App Store, and search for JWT Editor. Select the extension and click Install. Now, access the lab and log in with the provided credentials, Winner Peter. Back in Burp, go to Proxy, HTTP History. The JWT Editor extension has highlighted the requests containing a JSON Web Token. Select the Get My Account request and send it to Repeater. In Repeater's request panel, we can see that the cookie session is indeed a JSON Web Token. If we select the token header, so everything before the first dot, we can see that the content is automatically decoded in the inspector panel. This is true for the second part as well, the token payload. The last part is the signature, which is usually generated by hashing the header and payload using a secret key. This means that if we try to change the rest of the token, the header or the payload, the signature will no longer match the data and will be rejected by the server. However, we know that this lab is vulnerable because the server does not verify the JSON Web Token signature. This means that we should be able to send any payload to the server, such as changing the subject from Winner to a different user we know exists, such as Carlos, and then be able to access their account. Do this by changing the value for the sub property in the Inspector tab. Click Apply Changes. Also make sure to change the URL's query string ID parameter from Winner to Carlos. We are logged in as Carlos. Now that we've seen how we can bypass the JSON Web Token authentication, we have to get access to the admin panel. We know that the admin panel is located on the admin page. If we did not know that, however, we could have found out by using Burp's content discovery functionality. All we have to do is right-click in the request panel, select Engagement Tools, Discover Content, and click on the Session is not running button. After a mix of crawling, guessing, and black magic, Burp discovers the admin page. Keep in mind that this functionality only works for the professional version. Let's go back to the browser and try to access the admin page. We get a message telling us that the admin interface is only available if logged in as an administrator. Back in Burp Proxy HTTP History, look for the Get Admin request and send it to Repeater. Just like before, when we accessed Carlos's account, we will try to change the JSON Web Token payload to access the admin panel. This time, we will be using the JSON Web Token tab that was generated by the JWT Editor extension. This way, it is easier to read and modify the JSON Web Token's content. We know that we only have access to the admin interface if logged in as an administrator, so what we can try first is to change the sub property from Winner to Administrator. As you can see, the JSON Web Token is automatically changed. Send the request. We have received access to the admin panel. Now, all that's left to do is to go to the Delete Username Carlos page, copy the path, go back to the Raw tab, and paste it in the request line. Send the request. We get a 302 found response. This seems to have worked. If we go back to the admin page, we can see the message "User deleted successfully." Also observe that the delete username Carlos path is no more. Back in the browser, we also see that the lab has been solved. This is it for today's tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye!